I know it's really simple and easy. With just one line of code, if you are using JavaScript, we can export our HTML document as PDF file. But what if you want to export any specific part or any specific element of HTML document? In that case, it might get tricky. So in this video, I'm going to show you how can you export or convert your HTML table into PDF with vanilla JavaScript. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. With the help of Live Server extension, let's open this index.html file in our default browser. You can see this is the result, and this HTML table UI design was built 2 weeks ago, and you can see I have added different features, something like you can filter or sort on specific data of an HTML table with that beautiful animation. Similarly, I have added their sorting feature as well, something like if your HTML's data they are arranged in ascending order, then they will be arranged in descending order if you click that specific heading, and vice versa. So this video's link will be given in the description below or at top right corner in iCard, you can find it out. Now inside this section with class name table header, next to that div with class name input group, I'm creating another div with class name export file, and inside that I'm creating label, and for the for attribute let's give export file, and also I'm giving class export file button. Now inside this styler CSS file, let's style that class export file button. Okay, that code was for the testing purpose, so let's remove that. And as you can see, I have already linked the style.css file. So inside the style.css file, let's style that label with class name export file button. As you know, label, it's an inline element, so let's give display inline block so that I can give specific height and width. So for the width and height, I'm giving 2rem. For the background, let's give this white color with some transparent value. And for the image, I'm giving URL. Inside that, let's give the location of image. I'm giving images slash export.png. And as you know, I'm using background shorthand property. So in the same line, I can give background position to center. And if I give slash, I can give the background size. For the background size, I'm giving 80%. And for the background repeat, I'm giving no repeat. And also let's give the border radius of 50% so that it could make circular shape. In the browser you can see. Now let's copy this code and paste it down there. When you hover that export file button at the time, let's give background color of white color, and also I'm giving transform scale to 1.15. so you can see when you hover there's no any smooth transition. So for that, for the class export file button, let's give transition duration to 0.2 second. For the timing function, let's give is in out. Now you can see when you hover, you are getting that smooth transition. Similarly, now for the label, let's give the title attribute. I am writing export file, and you can see when you take your mouse near to that export file button, you will get that dark tooltip. Similarly, next to that, let's create input with type checkbox. And for the ID, let's give the same value that I have given for the label inside that for attribute, that is export file. This is really necessary. So now you can see when you click that export file button, you are able to check checkbox. So it's only possible because of that for an ID attribute that I have given for the label and input element. Now you can see that checkbox. So let's hide that checkbox, okay? So for the input, let's give display none. Now you can see that checkbox that is hidden. Similarly, next to that input element, let's create another div with class name export file options. And inside that, again, I'm creating label. And for the first label, I don't want to give that for attribute. Instead, let's give export as, and with the help of this HTML entity, you can give extra white space. And also I'm giving another HTML entity. With the help of this, you can get that right arrow icon, something like this. So now it's time to style this class export file as well as the div with class name export file options. So for the class export file, let's give position of relative. And for the class export file options, let's give the position of absolute. I'm giving right to 0, and also let's give the width. For the width, I'm giving 13 rem, and I'm giving text align to center. Similarly, let's give some box shadow. For the box shadow, I'm giving x offset of 0, y offset to 0.2 rem. For the spread value, let's give 0.5 rem. And for the color, let's give this black color with some transparent value. So now you can see that box shadow. Once again, let's create label with 4 attribute. And for the 4 attribute, I'm giving the same export file. And instead of that, I'm writing PDF. Next to that, let's give image. For the source, I'm giving images slash pdf.png. Now you can see that image is really huge, so let's give some proper width and height. So let's duplicate the same code. And now for the width, I'm giving 2 rem, and for the height, let's give auto. I have to give the image. Okay, now you can see that proper size of the image. As you can see, I have given the export file to position of absolute. And for the table setting, I have given the position of sticky. So because of that, our export file option, they are taken at the back. So now for the class export file options, if I give gindex of 100, or you can give 1 as you wish. Okay, you can see now it is brought to the front. Okay, now let's style the label that is within the div with class name export file options. So let's duplicate the same code, and instead of that image, let's give label. That display block was not necessary, you can remove that. And for the width, let's give 100%, and also let's give display flex. Justify content to space around, and also let's give align items to center. Similarly, let's give some padding. For the top and bottom, I'm giving 0.6 rem, and for the left and right, 0. And also I want to give the background color. For the background color, let's give this light gray color. Similarly, for the class export file options, let's give border radius of 0.5 rem. But in the browser, you can't see any kind of rounded corner around that box. So if I give overflow to hidden, did you see that rounded corners around that box? Similarly, let's duplicate the same code and let's take it down. Now for the level, I'm giving pseudo class first of type. So for the first level that is within the div with class name export file options, I'm giving padding of 1 rem to top and bottom, and for the left and right, let's give 0. Similarly, for the background color, I'm giving that same light green color that I have given for the class delivered. Now in the browser, you can see first level with green background color. Once again, let's copy this code and paste it there. Now when you hover that label, at the time we don't need this code, let's remove that. Let's give the transform scale to 1.05. And let's duplicate the same transition code. Let's copy and paste it inside that label. Now in the browser. Okay, I have to change that background color. For the background color, let's give this white color. So now you can see when you hover, you're getting that white background color with zoom in effect. So what if I duplicate more label elements in the browser, you can see. So now what I want to do is that when you click that export file options, I want to show and hide that different options. Okay, so for that, I just need to take the help of that input element. As you can see, that input, that is the checkbox. So for that input type checkbox, we can give check pseudo class. So in the standard CSS file, what you can do is that you can duplicate that code and let's take it down. So now whenever your checkbox that is checked, okay, I can give that check pseudo class. At the time, you can copy this class export file options, and if I give plus and paste it there, plus that is necessary, okay, that represents exact next sibling of that input element. I think it's better to take this code at downside. So now when your checkbox that is checked, at the time for the class export file options, let's bring this gindex at the downside. And also initially for the class export file options, we'll give opacity of 0. For the transform, I'm giving a scale of 0.8. And for the transition, I'm copying and pasting the same transition code that I have given there. And now let's duplicate the same opacity and transform code and bring it to that input Z code, and let's change that transform scale to 1. Similarly, when you hover that export file button at the time, I want to give cursor to pointer so that it would represent you can click that button. And if I click, okay, we're not getting that export file options. Oh, it's because I have forgot to change that opacity to 1. So let's change that opacity to 1. And in the browser, you can see when I click, did you see that? We are getting that export file options. And once again, if I click, that will be hidden. But I want to change the transform origin, okay? So for the transform origin, let's keep top right. So now in the browser, you can see when you click that export file button, scale property that I have given for the export file options, they are scaling up from top right corner. Okay, now what if I click that options? Did you see that all the options, they are hidden? So that is the reason why I have gave the for attribute for that label, and that value that must be matched with that ID attribute that I have given for the input type checkbox. Okay, it's just a kind of trick with the help of which, without using any JavaScript code, I mean with the help of just pure CSS, you can add this kind of feature. And also I have noticed there, when you hover that export as file, that background changes into white color. As you can see, for the first label, I have already given the background color to green color. And along with that, if I give exclamatory sign important, with the help of that, I can get rid of that problem. Similarly, when you are hovering that label, at the time I think I have to give the cursor to pointer, okay, so that you can get that pointing hand icon. Now let's remove these different options, just let's skip these two labels. For the first label, I'm giving ID. For the ID, I'm giving to PDF. With the help of JavaScript code, we need to select this element. Before that, let's take it to the full screen by pressing F11 key. So now when you click that PDF option, you need to convert your HTML table into PDF file and export it. Okay, before doing anything, I will give different comments for different codes. So what kind of operation these codes are, you know, like handling, I want to give some hints comments. Okay, so with the help of this code, we are giving the source functionality for our HTML table. Similarly, with the help of this code, we are sorting or ordering our HTML table's data. Now we are converting our HTML table to PDF. So I'm creating constant variable PDF button, and I'm assigning document.querySelector. So we are selecting the label with ID to PDF. Now for that PDF button, I'm giving event handler. So I'm writing PDF button dot on click. So now whenever you are clicking that PDF button at a time, let's call this to PDF function. Before that, I want to show you something. In index.html file, for that label, if you give on click attribute, and inside that, if I write window dot print, with the help of this print method, now you can convert this whole HTML document into PDF. You don't need huge lines of code, you know. It's really as simple as that. But what if you want to convert some part of HTML document? I mean, if you want to print out, or if you want to convert any specific part of HTML document. In that case, you have to write some few lines of code. First of all, for this main element, I want to give the ID. So let's give this ID customer table, and in the JavaScript file, let's create constant variable customer table, and I'm assigning document.querySelector. So we are selecting that main with ID customer table. Now when you click that PDF button, at the time we're calling to PDF function, and within that function we'll pass that customer table variable as a parameter. Okay, but you can see I haven't created that to PDF function, so it's time to create to PDF function. So within that function, I need to take that customer table as parameter. And inside that function, I'm creating constant new window variable, and I'm assigning window.open. So now with the help of that open method within your browser, you will be able to open totally new document. I mean new window. Now in the browser, let's look at that again. So if I click that PDF option in your browser, did you see that totally new tab that is opened again? And if I inspect, did you see that there is no any HTML element within that document? So we are not getting anything in our browser. So I'm writing new window dot document dot Right, so inside that document I want to give specific element, that is our customer table. So in order to do that, as you can see in the index.html file, I have already given id customer table for that main element, and in JavaScript file I have selected that customer table. Now we can pass the same customer table variable inside that write method, and along with that you need to give inner html of that element. Once again in the browser, if I click that PDF option, did you see that new window? And if you inspect the element, you can see we have created two sections. So now let's copy this main element, and along with that I need to give the CSS links, like if you want to print out exact look and feel of your HTML table. In the JavaScript file, let's create constant HTML code variable, and I'm assigning backtick. So in your keyboard, just above the tab button or next to number one key, you can find out this symbol. This is what you call template literals. With the help of this, it is easier to manipulate our string and the variables. So now inside that backtick, I'm pasting that HTML code that I have copied, and now we don't need this ID. Let's close this main element. Now instead of giving customers table's inner HTML there, let's cut and paste it inside that main element, and for the document dot within that write method, we'll pass that HTML code variable, and also we have to give the CSS link. For that, let's copy and inside that backtick, let's paste it there. And as you know, customer table, that was the variable that I have created with the help of JavaScript code. So now I need to select this code and wrap it inside the curly bracket, and if I give dollar, now it is no more string. Once again in the browser, if I click that PDF option, did you see that we are getting the exact customer table that we have in the index.html file? And if I inspect, did you see that we are giving the CSS link, as well as we are adding the exact customer table element, that is the main element, within our document. Now once again in the JavaScript file, just below that, if I write new window.print, with the help of this print method we are printing our new window. Now you can see we are able to print the document, but the layout, that is totally messed up. So it's because, as you know, our style.css file that contains few lines of code, and that takes few seconds to load, okay? So because of that, we are not getting the exact layout that we want. So now with the help of set timeout function, we can delay some time, you know, while we are printing that document. So now for the set timeout function, for the timeout, that means the time that you want to delay, I'm giving 0.2 second, that means 200 milliseconds. And inside that, you can take that print code, and also as soon as you print your document or when you cancel, I want to close that new window, okay? So for that, again I can give new window.close. So now with the help of this close method, as soon as when you print or cancel, your new windows will be automatically closed. If I click that PDF option, did you see that after 0.2 second we are printing our document? And let's change the layout to landscape, and also let's change some additional settings. For the page size, let's change it to tabloid. And if you want background image colors, you have to check that background graphics option. And if I hit save button, you can give any proper name for your PDF file. If I hit save, let me preview the PDF file that we have just downloaded. So as you can see, this is our PDF file, and we are getting the exact HTML table. So in this way, we have finally converted and exported our HTML document, I mean HTML table, into PDF. Similarly, if you want to create like separate window, something like you want to give different height and width, different position, then within that open method, for the third parameter, you can pass the string, something like I'm giving width to 500, which is the pixel, and you have to separate the value by comma. For the height, I'm giving 600, which is also the pixel, and for the top, let's give 0. For the URL and target, I'm giving empty. Once again in the browser, if I hit that PDF option, did you see that we are getting new window with different height and width? So this is it. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn. So keep learning.